We mwega mwiroleri wa Kikuyu Diaspora Television. Nijitakuwa Jeremy Damaris. Na daku nyitoke ni negeza tukotu kimulika kidu gitakuwa Mother's Day. Na Mother's Day ni mudhenya munene muno. Okora kwa celebrate wa there or there. Na muno kwa jafrulini wa United States of America. Na ikora kwa celebrate wa Najira nene muno. Frulini wa Kenya onakunoe celebrate wa Najira nene muno. No gweshiri ya frulini wa Kenya kila dumekaka ni kwa dekani la message. No mationa nagia muno na shiko tole ya frulini wa America. Kukora kukiona niyo nashiko najira nene. Mwenta wa mwode wa Mother's Day wajire ili 1908 then wafurini wa United States of America neguwa Mother's Day yajire ili ya go celebrate wo. Na kabeng ya kwa jeke doge toko Mother's Day yajire ili 1905 mwaka wa agiriye magana keda ma idhano na wajire ili ni mwode weta kwa Ann Jarvis ali mwana wa mwode weta kwa Ann Reeves Jarvis mutumia weho wale ketie kukwe na kukwa mutumia weyo kana mwiri tu yoni ya celebrate kana kulirika na mamua osho weta kwa Ann Reeves Jarvis na madam wogo to Ann Jarvis na kia kikugane wakia beli ya campaign negeza doze makuro mage celebrate mudhenya wa Mother's Day makuro makiririka na atumia neto doa mawira mega maneka orosho doa mukiriru na ajiraje kako kumona na wa United States of America nekuha kire na agusha na ugetweka mudhenya shudua gono celebrate wo noga yage taidi ya kendo 19 mwaka wa 1908 ukiheto kio wadho na ugetweka ate orosho wago celebrate taka atumia niogwekirwo na niogwekirwo bitalo no kejago celebrate no horo wajiri kudu gwitako west a Grafton West Virginia to niko mutumio wetako Ann Jarvis akoragware na niko a celebrate ire gikuo kyanyina kuria kudu gwitako Saint Andrews Methodist Church kuria mwana wa Grafton West Virginia kuniko majiri celebration sia Mother's Day na kumahidio aginyo muthyo yo muthenya wa Mother's Day niokoragwo celebrate wo najira nene ona gutuka thuthocio 1920 mudugo to Jarvis ni akorirwa kenja kuregana riu no horo wa go celebrate horo wa Mother's Day ni tondu kionereria giake kiari atumia makorogo mage celebrate na makorogo mage ciona o maundu mega ni ciana cia wathuri ao kana hima makorogo mage celebrate horo wa mutumia ni tondu wa maundu maria mwega mutumia akoragwe kete no Ann Jarvis ni onire kabuni ge ta Hallmark na companies ge ni ciajiri kuthondeka kindu gitako gift cards na maundu mage mahua medagio muthenyo cio wa Mother's Day na kionate kioneki yake gitiari muthenyo cio gathondeka guo besha na kukua kejiria ni kwa jiria campaign ya kulegana na mudhenya wa Mother's Day. Ododota hotia kuhota kekana ni kukunya tuselebrate ka Mother's Day mudhenya wa mudhe. Itodo states nyingi dhini wa America. Nesia kwa litosia hitokia wei wadho na kugwa mudogo ito Ann Jarvis. Akire mwone kurugamia ohorowegi Mother's Day. Na Mother's Day ni yage dhiri ya kukunya kenja kuselebrate wa mafruline mage. Ona kutuka fruline wa India ni yajira hidi yetene muna todo yeta kwa Petro Paksha. Ni yajira hidi kuselebrate wa hukafere kafrewe na ona kukua Amerika yeta na ajeno yeta kwa Petro Paksha. Na kukua Amerika yake jirigo ito a Mother's Day. Na ndrami nyo na kuri ole ni celebrate kama mwanyu emuyo kana hi yahurukete ni wega ni celebrate ari atutigetwa nao mari muoyo ni tondu ni horo mwega muno mutumia mutumio ngita ngitara mawira mari atumia marutaga ni makorogo makiruta mawira mega muno especially makoroga mia mishi ona madiko ni makoroga matabulite mutumia na jirane muno ona nokyo Kristo acagurire mutumia kana nokyo ji Kristo agereire he mutumia wetagwo Mary nigetha agiuke kuhonokia kiridiku gwatumia ni afata muno na nikyo ginya ngai onire ni wega obire mundu mutumia eta muteithia nikwenda gukorera clip cigana na ore celebration ire kiro guko mwena wa America ni Kenyans amwe ari amego ku mwena wa Birmingham City kuna mara semana ite kandai nemwe na mara kona muthenya munene muno wa celebrate muthenya wa Mother's Day nigetha gorogi kuni ona ku America andu matikorogo methuza muno especially Kenyans ari makorogo mokire guko ni mayu kirio ndu cio wa Americans na makeja guko celebrate na jira nene muno ni marugaga makaria na atumia makaheo kona ni takanithi makaheo chance makahujia na hi makainithi na wageka maundu matiganite ni korogi kuria clip cigana ona cia kanitha turacerete guko mwena wa Birmingham City ngaje kurathimia ukirorera clip ino jitagwo Jeremy Damaris guthie na wega tigwe na wega itikagiria tonene kugo ni wamenya horo wigi Mother's Day bitu akurathime na niwega onawe ugagitea mamuanyu kana mutumia waku kana mutumia wa hau hanyu ituraini niwega ukimutambura otogu Ann Jarvis edaga gutambura kana gutura aririkanaga mamu wao ni jitagu Jeremy Damaris. God bless you na tukerage mutambuini wa Kikuyu Diaspora Television.
You are great, O Lord, mighty is your name. muthenya wa umuthi thini wa kanitha wa Rigase Christian Church mwena wa Birmingham City githomo kiuma kia mwanya ni amu umuthi gigutongoragio ni atumia thini wa worship thini wa praises ona thini wa mahujio githomo kiajiriria madha maria kiabagiriria atumia ni magoire jukwaini na majiriria guthathaya watheru otorea kurathi na mbere mutumia wa mutungatiri wa kanithoi wa Rigase Christian Church atongoria ashirika othe na nyimbo cia kugoca Ngai kuria mainire na gikeno kinene muno magikungwira aciari na magikungwira uhotani munene uria Ngai witu amekeire todo muthenya muthe uma wa mwanya muno nigukorirwo na kahinda karya ciana ikorirwo ikiheo kanya ga gukorwo magitambura aciari ao
I want to appreciate every mother in this church. I think every man loves us, and that's why I see men here who came to be with us this morning. I just before we go ahead with our program, I want to invite Catherine. She's a future mother, being a lady. She'll just speak a word or two about her mother. And then while on that, I'll not favor just the ladies. Stephen, you can have two or three words for the mothers too. So Catherine, just come and tell us just something little about mothers, and then we can go from there.
We want to celebrate them because they love us with all our hearts, and they care for us, and they give us shelter, and they'll always be in our lives forever.
Amen. Stephen, just have two words for our mothers. Let's welcome Stephen in the house.
Happy Mother's Day. How y'all doing today?
Good.
I was talking to Bubba Lenny yesterday, and he asked me to talk about mothers and what mothers mean to me. And so I was looking at the scripture, Proverbs 6, verse 20, and it says, My son, keep your father's commands and do not forsake your mother's teaching. Bind them upon your heart forever and fasten them around your neck. And I was thinking, like, how God made the family to set it up. As a father to be the head and make the rules, but it's really the mothers who raise the children, who teach them how to grow up in the right way. So I think about what a mother is. A mother is the first one that you call when you're in trouble. The one that you can talk about everything. So a mother is caring, protecting, and understanding.
Oh, yes.
Mothers are the vessels of honor God utilizes to intercede for the family. And that's a word that I've learned. My mom uses it a lot, that the mothers are really the ones who intercede when the family is broken. Like, my mom's the one who's always praying.
Oh, yes.
Whether it's for the children, for the church. And the mother is the one who sets the tone in the house. For when the mother is happy, the whole family is happy.
Yes. Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
So her smile is infectious and her laughter is contagious.
Yes.
And then I was thinking about when Jesus died on the cross for us, like, he's there and the person he sees, the Bible mentions it. Everything the Bible mentions, there's a reason. So Mary is there when Jesus is on the cross and her son is about to die. And God doesn't say anything about Joseph. It's just Mary was there. And in John 19, verse 25, it says, near the cross of Jesus stood his mother. When Jesus saw his mother there and the disciples whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, dear woman, here is your son. And to the disciples, here is your mother. From that time on, the disciples took her into his home.
Yes.
And this demonstrates how Christ loves and cares for his mother, giving us a lesson of how we should treat our mothers.
Stephen Kiburu. Kiugo kaya gukora gukiheanwo ni Florence kana nyina wa Kiguru na gukuhanago
Samuel, those experiences, the heartaches that people took you through, it's a high time as people of God, as these children of Israel were told, forget them. Wanasifiwe. Do not dwell on the past. Hallelujah. Because our future does not determine where we have come from. Our future is greater than our past. Let us not dwell on the past. Let us focus forward. And the major word that I was saying in the verse 19 is a see, hallelujah. See, I am doing a new thing. He was telling them to see. I could imagine them that they are in a hard situation, and now God tells them forget and see. Hallelujah. He is not telling them that you don't have bread now, and this is the bread. See, I give you this bread. He was not telling them that. He was telling them to see not from the natural perspective. Yes, yes. He was telling them to open their spiritual eyes, that they may be able to see that God is doing something new. When I see feel it, that to see from the not from the natural, but that from the supernatural.
Hallelujah.
To see not something that is visible, but to see something that was invisible to them. When I see feel it. And God is telling us this morning, can you see it? Hallelujah. Can you see something good coming out of whatever you're going through?
Amen.
Can you see a breakthrough out of your headaches?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
If you don't have a job, do you see yourself getting a job tomorrow?
Yes.
Do you see a breakthrough in your life?
Yes.
If you don't have papers, can you see them?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Because we don't see in the natural.
Yes.
We do not see in the supernatural.
Yes.
And know that something good is coming out of us.
Yes.
There's no way we can be able to go or even to move on.
Yes.
We see the bright men that they cannot be able to go without being guided. But if they have somebody who has sight and guide them, then they are secure and they can know, I'm going to make it. Hallelujah. But even we see the blind man Myers, when he heard Jesus Christ that was passing by, he cried out, Jesus, Jesus, Son of David. And Jesus, he had already passed blind man Myers, and he didn't even open his eyes, and he was still blind. But Jesus, he was called by the blind man Myers, and he said, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. And he was like, what do you want? And he said, I want to see. Because there's something good when we are able to see. We pray that God would open our spiritual eyes.
Yeah.
That would have discernment in our spirit.
Yeah.
That would know that it seems like it's darkness right now. But I know my morning is coming. May God open our spiritual eyes. And it says, it continues to say that now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? Can you see it? Because it's springing up. We see that in this nation we can experience different types of seasons. And you know when spring comes, I remember Alice was telling me that they have these flowers. They don't see them many times. But when spring comes, they see yellow flowers, they spring up. And they didn't plant them. They have been there when they bought their house. And then they don't last long, they just disappear. Born as a fuel. It's just like that. Something that is not there, you can't see
yes,
it.
Yes.
But when that time comes, it's going to spring up. Born as a fuel.
Yes.
Something good is springing up for you, my sister, my brother. Something good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is saying that I am making a way in the desert.
Yes.
It doesn't matter where you are. In your desert, there is a way. Hallelujah. There is a breakthrough.
Yes.
Where there is no way. Because Jesus Christ is the word, He is the truth, He is the life. As long as we depend on Him and we focus on Him, He is the way. Hallelujah. Call unto Him even in your desert. A desert is a place where a place of nothingness. A place where there is nothing good that can come out of it. But He is saying, I'm making a way to
you.
Hallelujah. Your situation may look like a desert. You may think like you're just there by yourself. But Jesus Christ promises this thing. I am your way. Hallelujah. Trust on me. Amen. Hallelujah. And I am making streams in the wastelands. The wastelands are places probably like those who come from Africa. Are places we could not even plant anything. Because nothing could come out of it. You know? But God is saying that even He is making streams there where nothing could grow. He is making streams there. When I say, praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The book of John chapter 16 says that Jesus was talking to his disciples and He was telling them, until now, the book of John 16 verse 24, you have not asked me anything. in my name. But now, after he has gone to the cross, after he has been resurrected and conquered the cross and conquered death, whatsoever you shall ask in the name of Jesus, whatsoever we shall ask the Father in the name of Jesus, we shall receive it. Amen? Amen. Ask anything. What do you need God to do to you? What do you need, my sister, my brother? He is the way. He is the truth. And he is the life. But we need to see. Hallelujah. We need to see our blindness to not to be there. Amen. We see in the book of Isaiah chapter 6. When Isaiah experienced the glory of God in the temple. And when he experienced the glory of God in the temple, and then he was purged on his lips with the coal from the altar. And then the angel of the Lord was crying out. He was saying, who shall go for us? Or whom shall we say? Amen? Amen. And Isaiah, he had already been purged, and he was still the prophet. He said, here I am. Send me. When I feel it. And he was told, go to those children of Israel, them who have ears but they do not hear, they have eyes but they do not see, they have a heart that do not understand. Praise be the name of the Lord. And he was told, go and tell them to shut their ears and to shut their eyes and to shut their heart. Amen. So that they cannot see with their natural eyes, that they can be able to see with their spiritual eyes. Amen? Because that which God was promising them, it is something greater than what they could even perceive with their natural heart. He was promising them something more glorious, something that cannot be experienced in the natural thing. He was telling them, go shut your eyes now, because I want you to see from the supernatural. I pray that God will make us be able to see, that we'll be able to shut our hearts and our souls and our minds and our ears, that we are not going to judge things in the natural way, but we are going to know in the supernatural way, that I'll know this is not where I am. I am heading farther. I have a breaking through. Because whenever we go through fire, the book of Isaiah in the beginning, it talks about even when they went through fire, or even through the flooding, they are not going to be overflown. And God is saying, even when you're in that situation, you may be like you in the fire. But God is saying that it's not going to burn you. You may be in the fire and still striving forward. I had this description. Somebody was saying that a rocket does not just go from nation to nation. A rocket goes from dimensions to dimensions. And that which propels a rocket, it is the fire. When we see the rockets going up, it has to be propelled by fire. So whenever you're going, we are at the fire. Hallelujah. You're being propelled to go farther. There is no time to mama. There is no time to mama. There is time to go farther. Hallelujah. Not from one place to another, but it is propelling from one dimension to the other. Hallelujah. That is how we say we are able to move from one glory to the other. God is promising us as individuals that we are able to go far. Even in our turmoil, in our fire, we can go far. Amen? He promised the children of Israel in the book of Haggai 2 verse 9. He promised them, it was the house of God they were building. And he told them that the latter glory shall be more glorious than the former. Hallelujah. Yes. He was telling them the latter glory. Yes. The glory that is coming behind this one we see. It is more glorious than the former. Amen. Yes. Let us just see Haggai chapter 2. Just for a minute. So that. Hallelujah. In the book of Haggai, it tells about how some servants of the Lord were called to build the house of the Lord. Amen. And in the chapter 2, they had already gone and got the timber and everything that they needed. And as I was thinking, let's start from verses 3. Who of you is left who saw this house in its former glory? How does it look to you now? Does it not seem like nothing, but now be strong. God is asking them, how do you see now? Because the house that was demolished, it was more beautiful. You know the house of Jerusalem, how it was built with all, how Solomon built the house. And that house had been demolished. And now they had been called to rebuild the house of the Lord. But this time they're not building with those expensive and glorious things that King Solomon built with. They were told to go to the mountain and get deeper and come and make the house of the Lord. And he was asking them, how do you see it? Because it doesn't, in the natural,
thutha wa gethomo kuthira muthenya wa umuthi ni urikiririo na irio mwanya mwanya ni amu andu no nginya mangikungoire uhoro wigi aciari na gwagitweka umuthi irio igukoro igicavo ni athuri othe na anake ona imwana ira cikiuma kanithaini ucio kugu atumia maikarire thi makro magitugwo na wendo muingi muno ni athuri ao anake ao ona ciana ciao cia anake Irio shuma shia mutheba mitheba mitheba gorani gorani kuma mwena wa Kenya naoni ya kila kigeniri ya muno ne dhabudha ne todo jiregeta kulea dhabudha ori muetene hawamu kuyo kulea mwena wa Kiabu. Nyama shia hiyo shuma kuo ngoko shuma nyige mshere wa pilau karanga shio dheni mshere iria igo kogwe ya gerwa dheni wa kanitha wa Regas Christian Church. Na igogona rĩu rĩkĩrĩkĩrĩire na ũgemio mũnene mũno nĩ amu andũ othe mainũkire makenete na amwe ao matinaga o kaũndũ ga kuga kegiĩ mũthenya ũyũ mũnene wa gũkũngũĩra atumia.
Something. Hi, how are you? How do you feel being in Kenya's church? Wow, do you enjoy African food?
Very good.
What do you like there most?
Samosas.
Samosas?
My favorite.
Wow, thank you very much. Hi, ma'am. How do you feel being in African church? Love it. So how do you like the worship, the praises, the preachings?
Everything is so family.
Wow. God bless you.
Yeah, my name is Dennis Kiari. I'm from Birmingham, but Kenya from Kiambu. Today is Mother's Day. And I want to wish my mom and all the other mothers out there a special happy Mother's Day. You know, women are important, and they're a big part to society. If they weren't here, if they weren't here, we wouldn't be here. So it's good to uphold, respect all women. You know, all women, and not just on this day, but every other day of the year. If you're here, you're in Kenya, no matter what part of the world you're at, to respect them and give them that honor. You know. Respect them as mothers. So happy Mother's Day to you, mom, and to all the other women. Thank you.
Mothers, do you manage a few? Network and a new remote to appreciate men as a mothers. We are really grateful to be honored. Na nitwalea, nitwaigwa kiugo. We are blessed.
My name is Diana, and I want to shout out to not only my mom, but the rest of the moms that are in this church and around the world. Thank you for taking care of us for when we were born and now from our today. And thank you for giving us food, clothes, and discipline for the rest of our lives.
I wish all mothers in Kenya happy Mother's Day. Na rĩa megũkũ na rĩa othe me thĩ ciothe cia kũraya ndamendera happy Mother's Day. Yeah.
Kwanyu nĩ kũ?
Gwitũ nĩ ikino mwena wa Kiambu, Kenya. Ngũgicĩra mũtumia wĩtagwo nyina wa Cirũ, nĩ mũtumia wa my father ũrĩa mũnini, na wicĩre mwarimũ Victoria nĩ my auntie, nĩ sister ya baba wakwa. Yep.
Hi, this is Eva. You know who it is. I love y'all, and y'all mean a lot to me. And happy Mother's Day.
Okay, my name is Catherine Wajikothuo.
My name is Mary Wanmaida Wanjiro.
And today's Mother's Day, and here is a day when we celebrate all the mothers here. We get the flowers, whatever we want, like just to celebrate the mothers.
Today is Mother's Day. We give them thanks to them. We give them flowers. We give them all the help we need. We love them, and we in Legacy Church, we pray to them. We sing to them. We sing for them, and then
There we go.
Okay. My names are Naomi Wendia Derry, and I'd like to wish all the beautiful mothers a happy Mother's Day, and may God bless you, and we thank you very much.
Hari to njeta go Cynthia Muthoni na nigeenda mwathani ni undu wa kuhonokia na kunyenda guko America ni to celebrate ga Mother's Day ni tondu mothers ni koragwo very important ni tondu kuria tumete ni undu wa ciari to gutwe ni undu wa mothers gutwenda ana nigeenete muthenya wa muthe muno ni undu wa gukorwo twina Mother's Day na ni to celebrate wega na ni twakenera ngai ni undu wa undu ucio amen.
Happy Mother's Day. You know, here in America, we really appreciate Mother's Day. You know, they do a lot for us. My mom got me this sprite right here. Well, happy Mother's Day, though.
Umuwe ni muthenya wa bata muno. Muthenya wa kuririkana aciari aria matuciarite. Na tugithie back to the Bible. Mwathani we mwene niangeto mire ona mulwe Jesus Christ okay on another way no niwega okay through a woman. So women are very special people niandu apata muno na twage ni kumatea na nikio tokirio muthi uchokia ngatho nundu acierito amare guku ona ala mare Kenya ona ala mare ku Kenya tumandikanete tukauga Mwathani aromoge matukumange mainge ni tondu tumete kuri andu apata aciari muri andu abata atimia amadu ciarite ona amadu ciarite haraho the mari ni andu abata mono Mwathani amurathime. Thank you very much.